Just a six here, guys, with my new servo mount tray. This is a piece of nylon PVC from a printer. It was black. I've sprayed the top of it white, obviously. It was 21.5 centimeters in depth. Next, I put some 7mm square timber and epoxied that to the bottom of the hull with a screw in the main stanchion there. Then, as you can see, we can slip this plate in. It's a little tight, but it does work. And of course, once it's below decks, you can raise it to the top. I left some space on both sides so that you can rotate it. And then that'll be screwed down to the timber mounts. Move this camera a bit. And that allows for some forward and aft movement. I haven't selected the screw position yet, but then our rudder servo mounts in like so, if we can get the wires out of the way. The whole point of this is so that I can remove the whole thing if necessary. So move the lighting a bit here. There we go, that's a bit better. So you can see the servo fits in quite nicely. We can move that forward or aft. Aft being to the left, of course. So we took the stock servo arm that came with it, and I made a piece of aluminium. I put a couple of Allen head screws, self-tappers, through it just to give it some support, and epoxied it as well. And you can see there's a ball joint on the lower end there. I've allowed for an extra piece of that to go on the port side when I go to a dual push-pull system. Carbon fiber rod with ball joint ends on it, straight out of my old heli, 450. This is the original rudder arm that goes on the aft. You can see I put the ball joint in there temporarily to test, and also added some epoxy to the nylon grips on both ends of the threaded rod. Moving right along, that eyelet obviously will fit over that ball joint there, and there'll be another one on the arm. And this is my new arm, hand machined from my sore fingers. Basically, you can see it's a lot wider than the original, and I can allow for I've allowed for the extra arm on the push-pull system if I decide to add that. So it will go here. I haven't shown you the brass screw that goes through the side to lock into the flat, but you can get the idea. It goes from the aft side there. And I've put the ball joint on the starboard side. This current carbon fiber rod will fit through and clip onto the ball joints there, like so. Plenty of clearance, penguin, from the winch servo. And enough room on the other side for that. Also have to put some opening, enlarge the openings in the transom there to allow for some clearance.